You know, despite the rumors and everything, I didn't think I'd be doing this tonight, but we got the Spider-Man No Way Home trailer. I've been doing this for a long time. I feel like it's important to kind of document experiencing things like this for the first time. I've done it with Star Wars trailers. I've done it with huge movies in my life, games in my life, and stuff like that. And for some of you guys who've been watching me for a really long time, I've been doing this for like 10 years. So if you've been watching me since pretty much it, or maybe even just like on and off, number one, thanks for being here. But number two, you know that the Sam Raimi Spider-Man movies are like a huge part of my life, my kind of coming of age. And I don't want to go as far as to say my identity. That's like, let's relax. But dude, I don't know. So this is crazy. This is a big deal. Also, as this goes on, I can't really show the trailer too much. I don't want this video to get like copyright flagged. Sony is bad with that. So it's going to be just a lot of me yapping. So go make a pot of coffee or something, unless you want to look at my mug a lot. It is all seemingly happening like we thought, or how the internet was kind of adding things together. And the trailer's here, and can I just say, give me the blue light, Rosie, yeah! So this is great, just because I don't have like the biggest stake in the MCU Spider-Man movies. As much as I really enjoy the MCU, and there's a lot of great things about this interpretation of Peter Parker, Spider-Man, there are a lot of other interpretations that I prefer. And I'm not just saying Raimi or you know, Tobey Maguire or Andrew Garfield or anything like that. I'm talking about like Insomniac Spider-Man, different comic books and stuff like that, just stuff I prefer. So that, I don't know what that is leading to, but what I'm trying to say is that it's exciting that we're getting crazier for the MCU Peter. Specifically, and I'm not even talking about the crazy shit yet, but specifically, what I got a sense from this trailer is like Spider-Man problems, which is something I love about Spider-Man and Peter Parker, is that as much as he's like, haha, happy-go-lucky, foo, there's always a lot of emotional baggage and like sometimes sadness, and it's teen problems, it's mid-20s problems, whatever it is. And while the MCU Peter Parker, the Tom Holland Spider-Man, has always had problems, and they do a good job here and there, you never really feel it for a while. It's usually just comes and goes and it's fixed. This trailer is already at least giving me vibes that like the Spider-Man problems are like real and substantial this time. And I like that. We're kind of getting like hints or vibes of like the Brand New Day arc a little bit. A lot of things are shown off in this teaser. There's a lot of Doctor Strange, which makes me really happy because there's a lot of imagery here that is totally evocative of the original Doctor Strange movie, which I love to see because that's one of my favorite ones. I love the MCU Doctor Strange specifically. I like their interpretation of Stephen Strange, except for what they're doing here with how they tried to cram an explanation of how the multiverse thing happens in this trailer, and it makes it seem like Stephen Strange was just goofing around, which that's definitely not the way it goes down. They must have had to have editors. I don't know. Regardless, I really hope that he shows up with some yellow gloves at some point, maybe in the Multiverse of Madness. I don't know, but I love him chilling. I love casual Doctor Strange, casual Steve, we can call him. Also, that is, can we talk, wow, that is Dr. Wig Strange. Wigter Strange. I think it's just really cool because it's like, it's we're getting kind of what a lot of us were hoping for, was like a Doctor Strange working with Peter and possibly opening up multiple universes and things going down, because obviously this trailer teases a bunch of stuff. Wow. So, can I just come back again? A lot of people dunk on the Raimi Spider-Man movies, and now you're all here and happy to play. I'm not gonna talk any trash. Happy to have you. Come on down. But there's a lot going on here. There's like a shot that's like you see lightning and you see sand. We know Jamie Foxx's Electro is gonna be there. So Sandman, Electro, the end teases Alfred Molina as Doc Ock again. And he looks incredible. He looks damn good. Like, it's like, I was very much like, oh, that there he is. That's the same character. It's not like other movies where they drag someone back out and you're like, why do they look like that? No, like he totally still pulls it off, the energy and everything, just from that one little shot. The biggest surprise for me really was seeing the Goblin pumpkin bomb. I didn't expect that. And I am gonna go out on a hot take here. I don't think we need to go that far. I really don't. As someone who just loves that original movie and Willem Dafoe's performance, it was so weird and strange and out there and just like a perfect moment in time. I think that Willem Dafoe Green Goblin thing should be like preserved in a glass canister like the rose from Beauty and the Beast, like never to be dragged out again for the entertainment of us again. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. I was like, oh, that was the only part where I'm like, oh, they're bringing him back. And like, I'm sure everybody else was really excited, but like, I don't know. I don't know. I'm saying that a lot. The big thing, and they didn't really tease it, but like, obviously, like everybody thinks, and there's been leaks and there's been rumors for months and months and months now, and new stuff every day that I don't even have time to get into, that we're getting Andrew Garfield and Tobey Maguire, Toby Tugboat Maguire himself. Here's the thing, man, I'm excited for that. I'm really excited for that. That's gonna be like a powerful emotional experience for me. Obviously Toby, but also, you know what, Andrew Garfield too. Come on, I could make a whole video on that, and I really should. I've never really gone on record here. I've gone on record on pretty much it and other things about those movies, but yeah, so they're gonna have these characters, and I don't think we're gonna see them as much as a lot of people are hoping. I don't think it's going to be this big thing for the entire movie. I'd love to be proven wrong, but this movie still has so many other things it needs to accomplish in terms of MCU Peter and MJ and everything going on and his identity crisis, and also cool Times Square shot of Peter with the classic split. That's an image, that's imagery that we all know very well. Love seeing that. But like, this movie's dealing with all of that, all the Doctor Strange stuff, all the multiverse stuff that doesn't even have to do with Spider-Man universes. And then we're also going to get Spider-Man characters. I don't think they're gonna have more than a few scenes. I mean, hell, there also apparently Daredevil might show up. So there's a lot that they have to work on here. And I am willing to just have a nice little taste, a nice little surprise of seeing those characters back. I do think some of the expectations are like getting to the stratosphere. And I think this first teaser was a nice way of just kind of giving us a taste, but not like blowing it out of the water, because who knows? But I'll take what I can get. Honestly, as someone who's been quoting the Raimi movies for my entire life, I am very excited to see a little something, you know? And honestly, even if we just get something like Doc Ock, if no other Spider-Men show up, I'll take it. Like, obviously, I think that would be a little bit of a disappointment, but still. But I'd be happy with just like, you know, like a quote here and there, a reference, a wink and a nod, you know, maybe Bonesaw shows up, a little bit of a Dashboard Confessional song, anything like that. I'm happy. I'm pretty easy to please, but on the other hand, it's still also weird just like picturing this in your head and reading the rumors and thinking about what could go down, and then like finally sitting here and watching the trailer and some of the things are starting to pop up and you're like, oh, wow. There it is. Sometimes it's weird to like process that stuff, you know? So like, I'm still working through this. I feel like a lot of you guys are too. And there's gonna be a million videos dissecting the trailer and pointing out Easter eggs and stuff like that. I do really wonder if I'm going to watch more trailers. I have a thing where I try and usually just watch the teaser trailer or the first real trailer and then nothing else. Sometimes I don't even go that far. Sometimes I watch nothing. I go on total media blackouts. So obviously it's hard to avoid a lot of stuff in 2021, but I like to really savor that experience. And this teaser trailer already showed me enough. You know, if they're leading up, they're like, oh, this teaser trailer is gonna give us just like little enemy glimpses. And then the first big real trailer shows us Tobias and Andrew Garfield. Then, all right, cool. But I don't even need to see that. I'm in. I think there was a dumbass rumor going around a while ago that it was like, Kevin Feige says that they're not gonna show any trailers. And everyone was like, what? And I was like, even if that was real, fine, do it. I'm gonna see the movie anyway. I'm a Spider-Man fan, I don't even care. It's just really interesting and really wild. And I just hope that whatever they do is tastefully done and still interesting and still a compelling story and doesn't feel like this half-ass, like Ready Player One dragged down Easter egg reference. Even though I'll still get a little teary-eyed from it, I want it to be good and meaningful and like emotionally resonant, you know? I also really don't want them to do the thing that sometimes they do in movies where like they take the previous generation and they play up their oldness. You know, Tobey Maguire's not that old. Just put him in the fucking suit again, all right? They don't, like, a lot of people have done really cool Photoshops of him looking older and wearing a different suit. No. Just Spider-Man, please. That's it. Spider-Man, please. Thank you. But again, I'm getting into it. Like, I have so many wants and demands, but I think it's important to just kind of like let it go and enjoy the ride. So that's what I'm doing. And I just wanted to document it, like my first thoughts seeing this, just because this is weird. I never really thought this was actually going to happen. And yet here we are. So I guess I'm overdue on talking about Spider-Man on this channel. I'm committed to Spider-Man. My Twitter banner for my Twitter banner has been the same image from Spider-Man 2 for probably about 10 years now. I actually thought there's another version of this video, like I had written up for a second, where I literally just speak in Raimi quotes, but we can't, that would be so cringy. That would be only for me. So we're gonna put that back in the vault. But I wanna know what you guys think about the trailer. If you did watch this teaser trailer, let me know. There's a lot to dissect. Obviously a lot of cool ass Doctor Strange stuff happening. There's hashtag Strange Train, which looks like a very cool sequence. What are they doing in the desert? Who knows? Who's gonna show up? Who knows? Is it James Franco? Definitely not. Let's talk about Spider-Man. I want to know what you guys are thinking. I want to know how you're vibing on this, how you're feeling on this, what Spider-Man franchise or group of movies you like the most. And keep your eyes peeled for eventual Spider-Man videos from me. I'm able to make videos like that that are kind of weird and out there because a lot of you guys fund me through Patreon and through the YouTube join membership thing. So thank you guys. But thank you, all of you guys who've decided to come here and watch a weird man in his bathrobe who is 30 talk about how Spider-Man is the most important thing to him in the whole wide world. That's strange to say as somebody who is married with a cat and a dog and a family, but hey, we're all working through this. So, wow, I should go. It's really late here. I don't usually make videos this late. Thanks for jumping on this ride with me. If you had fun, if you like listening to someone who literally just is here to talk about what they love, all you gotta do is click the like button. I would really appreciate that. Thank you. But guys, I'm Jake Baldino. Thanks for watching. Subscribe because video games. Pizza's on me.